Good morning. As I sit here today, reading what you're saying on social media, what you're asking at our call center, what you're writing to us, and what our partners are asking us on your behalf, I can fully understand your anxiety and concern. Some of your questions: will I get my money back? Why do I have to wait to get my money? When will I get my money? And what do I have to do to get my money are only natural. We had to make the extremely difficult decision to wind up six of our funds that we've managed for over 15 years, only because after exploring all options, we firmly believed this was the only viable option to preserve value for you. The COVID-19 pandemic and related lockdown made it impossible for us to continue to pay daily redemptions in these schemes. As you can see from the portfolio statement of these schemes that we've put up on our website, the funds had to resort to borrowing increasing amounts of money or sell off its most liquid papers, potentially at a high cost, in order to fund redemptions. This situation was unsustainable as it was harming those investors who remained in the fund at the cost of those leaving. And we recognized that this decision would cause you significant concern. And therefore, please believe me when I say that we did not take this decision lightly, nor did we take it without understanding its consequences, no matter how difficult they might be for us. If we had felt there was any other way of achieving the objective of preserving value for you, we would certainly have chosen it. But in the need to protect value, we could no longer offer daily liquidity, and that I know is the core cause of your anxiety. Let me also clarify that there was no default in any of the companies that we hold that caused us to make this decision. It was due to the liquidity issues in the market as a direct result of the COVID-19 lockdown that we had to take this step. The lockdown, unprecedented, at least in my lifetime, and though necessary to contain the spread of this disease, has had far-reaching consequences for all of us personally, just as it has caused severe dislocation in the market, particularly for the type of securities these schemes held in their portfolio. So what does winding up mean? It means that the fund still has its assets. It is still earning interest on its portfolio from the debt we have invested in. It is still continuing to receive payments from the companies we have invested in. But we are no longer able to accept money from investors or pay daily redemptions for the liquidity reasons I explained. Winding up does not mean we have written off any assets or given up any dues from our investee companies. Let me try to answer your most pressing questions. First one being, will I get my money back? And the answer to that question is an unequivocal yes. We will aim to balance between giving you the maximum amount and giving it to you in the shortest possible time. You may ask, how will we do this? As I said, the schemes have not lost their assets. We are continuing to receive interest payments and scheduled maturities, and we're talking to every company to see if they can pay us back in advance. And as the lockdown lifts and the market normalizes, we will make all efforts to sell the bonds we hold at the best possible price. The second question is, when will I get my money and why do I have to wait? This is a bit more difficult to answer precisely today for two reasons. One, the schemes have borrowed money to fund redemptions. Regulations require that we pay these borrowings first. If we simply look at the maturity schedule we have posted on our website, this shows that you can start to receive money as early as June in some of our schemes, but for others the wait is longer. And we recognize that this may be unacceptable for you. But what we cannot predict precisely today is how quickly the market will normalize and therefore how quickly we can liquidate the rest of the holdings. We have already started work on this and we will bring you more frequent updates. Another question many of you are worried about is, will I see big losses? Many of you have questions about the companies we've invested in. You may not recognize the names, and therefore you're concerned about whether these are solid companies with solid businesses that can actually pay back the debt that they owe us so that we can return that money to you. We will, over the next few days, help you understand many of the companies in our portfolio. Another question we're hearing is, do I need to do anything more to get my money? What are the next steps? Regulations require that we give you an opportunity to vote on the process to be followed for winding up of the schemes. We will shortly write to each one of you and to our partners with more details around this. We propose to conduct the voting electronically, as many companies do these days, and as within the lockdown, it is not possible to call a physical meeting. And we will give you more details of how we will secure your best interest in winding up the schemes. Our goal is not to do a fire sale at any cost, nor to make you wait till maturity, but to find the right balance between the two. We will also tell you exactly what oversight and control mechanisms we will put in place and how we will keep you informed on a regular basis. Finally, people may be concerned about whether their money is at risk and they could see losses. The schemes continue to be invested in debt securities, and just as when the schemes were open for subscriptions and redemptions, there was a risk that some company could face delays in paying us. That same risk exists even today. However, we fully expect to be able to recover maximum value for investors from all our companies. You may have questions about the borrowing and whether do we really have to repay the borrowing first, and will that take money away from you? We do have to actually pay off the borrowing first under regulations, but the schemes have assets to repay the borrowing in addition to assets equal to 100% of the declared NAV. Therefore, while we will be paying the borrowing first, it does not take away any value from the scheme's unit holders. If you look at the portfolio we've posted on the website, you will see, for example, that if a scheme had 10% borrowing, it will have assets equal to 110%, a negative cash balance of 10%, which indicates the amount borrowed, and therefore net assets of 100%, which make up the value of the NAV that we have declared, and which represents the holdings that we will sell or receive maturities from to return money to unit holders. Finally, many of you have expressed concerns about whether this impacts our other funds and therefore whether we are leaving India. Let me assure you that we are committed to being in India. We are working to return your money in these schemes at the earliest possible time, that there is no impact on the other schemes that we manage, whether fixed income, hybrid or equity. There is no reason to pull out of other investments that you have with us or in other high quality schemes across the industry in panic. We know many of you may not believe us today, but hopefully when you start to receive money in your bank accounts, you will have greater confidence in what we are telling you. And in the interim, we're committed to giving you as much transparency as we can into the portfolios and the process to help you understand that we are working as hard as possible to return your money to you. I know at this time, much of what we say may be difficult for you to accept. And I recognize that there are only two things we can do that may help reduce your anxiety in the short term. Answer your questions with transparency and start to return money as quickly as possible. And that is all my team and I are focused on. Please continue to reach out with your questions and concerns. Email us at service@franklintempleton.com. And my team and I will do our best to answer all your questions. Thank you again for listening.
Mutual fund investments are subject to market risks. Read all scheme-related documents carefully.